So thus far, we have seen two examples with classes. One, when we drew shapes using turtles, and then the other one, when we sent out text messages using Twilio. Now, when we created shapes using turtle, we wrote a line of code that read, Brad is equal to turtle.turtle. Now, what we're really trying to say with this line of code here is that inside Python, there is a file called turtle, and inside that file is a class called turtle. There it is. And when we try to access that class using this statement, especially with this open close brackets, what we're really doing behind the scenes is calling the init function defined inside the class. And what this function init does is that it initializes or creates space in memory for a new instance, which we called Brad. Brad is an object or instance of the class turtle. This instance Brad can then do things defined inside the class turtle, like move the turtle forward. Similarly, when we write a line of code that says client is equal to rest.twilio rest client, what we are really trying to say is that inside Twilio, there is a folder called rest. And inside that folder is a Python file which has a class called Twilio rest client. Now, when we call this line of code, the one where we access the class Twilio rest client with these open close brackets, what we are really doing is calling a function init defined inside that class Twilio rest client. And what this function init does is again initializes or creates space in memory for an object or instance of that class Twilio rest client. We call that object client. The object client can then do things defined inside that class Twilio rest client, like send SMSs or texts. So in summation, you can think of a class as a blueprint of a building. Now, this blueprint will have certain pieces of information about the building, like the number of rooms in the building, the area under the building, etc. Now we can use the same blueprint to build multiple buildings. For instance, a residential complex with yellow walls and an office building with blue walls. Similarly, a class, let's take the example of class turtle that we've used thus far. Now this has information about the turtle. For instance, how to make the turtle move forward, how to make the turtle turn right, etc. Now, we can use one class as a blueprint or a template to create multiple instances like Brad and Angie. Now, these instances, they can do things that are defined inside our class or blueprint. Things like move forward, turn right, and draw a circle. Now, recently, we've seen another class, and this class is called Twilio REST Client, which I have just abbreviated here for lack of space. This class has information about how to connect with Twilio and send a text message. And from this blueprint, we can then create an instance called client. Client can then do things that are defined inside the class, like send out texts. So you can think of a class as a blueprint, which have some basic information defined inside of them. And you can think of its objects as examples or instances of that blueprint.